Glory to the Lord. Today, this is Clear Vision, and I am Rose, and I am so blessed and privileged to be with you today. I'm privileged every time I get to be with you, whether it's through the television broadcast or whether you call me on the phone and you ask for me to pray with you, and I want to pray with you, so call me. Let me give you a powerful word from God for you. Today, we're going to get into a fabulous message that the Lord has given us, and it's called Joy Far Outweighs Pain. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to never have any pain anymore in my life, and I know some people that think that they need pain in order to have a good life. In other words, if you didn't have pain, how would you know joy? Well, honey, I don't have to have pain to realize joy. I don't have to be run over by a truck to find out that it feels good to not have been run over by a truck. That's positively ignorant thinking. So today we're going to learn how to judge ourselves by the degree that we are enjoying peace and health and life and love. And I want you to stay with me and pay attention to your offers for your books and call the ministry, and let's learn how to have a life of joy and not have a life of pain. I love you so much. I'm Rose, and I'll see you in just a minute.
Love says, keep it simple. This timely teaching by Rose will keep you loving and being blessed at all times. You'll learn how to never quit, surrender to love, take and make time, treasure time, and become a blessed spiritual athlete. Are you ready to live blessed beyond your dreams? Are you ready to be God's great blessing? Learn how to keep it simple. Order your book today and walk in divine health, increase your finances, and increase your joy and blessings. And remember to request your 30-day devotional, 30 Days, The Champion in You.
Glory to the Lord. Isn't it wonderful to be in the joy of the Lord? Nehemiah 8:10. Nehemiah 8:10. Let's look at Nehemiah 8:10 right now. Nehemiah 8:10 says, for the joy of and in the Lord is your strength, your refuge and stronghold. Glory to you, Father. When you were watching the offers on the books, Keep It Simple, I want you to order that book, because it talks about how to keep it simple in life. And one of the things we do to keep it simple is have the joy of the Lord. I want you to understand how to surrender to love and how to keep your life in abiding in the Lord and His Word, and keep your life in honoring Him with the joy of Him. And as I was studying out that scripture, the joy of and in the Lord is your strength, God stopped me and He said, Rose, I want you to pay attention to that scripture. Let's break it down. Because He said, joy is your strength. And joy is in me, and your strength is in me. But joy is your strength. Wow. Well, I got to thinking about that, and I thought, wow, if I'm going to have joy, and I'm going to have it in the Lord, then I've got to start looking for people and opportunities to make people feel important, because that's a joy. That's one of the things that's a joy. Another thing that I realize that's a joy is that if you will learn three jokes, and learn specifically three jokes that'll make children laugh. The favorite one we have in our family is knock-knock jokes, and then we have a little joke we love to play on each other called, if Pete and Repeat were walking down the road and Pete got run over by a car, who was left? And, of course, the answer is Repeat. Well, if Pete and Repeat were walking down the road and Pete got run over by a car, who was left? Repeat. And you can keep that going with a kid for hours, because they think that's funny. See, that's joy, and that's strength. That's joy in the Lord and His strength. I may not know a whole lot about a whole lot of things, but I know about the Lord, and I know about what joy is. And I know that illness and addictions and anger and unforgiveness pulls you toward despair and death. And I know that our spirits, our minds, and our hearts, even our bodies, many times are dying from a lack of love and joy. When you see somebody so despaired, so discouraged, or you yourself are feeling that, that's because you're having a lack of that love of God in your life, a lack of His joy. Because God's joy brings life to your spirit. God's joy gives you a sense of hope and love and faith. God's joy gives you hope even when you hurt. God's joy helps you notice the sun is shining. Amen? Have you ever gone through a time in your life and one day you just looked out and you said, my goodness, I didn't realize that I hadn't noticed the sun is shining. Or you stop and you think, wow, I see clouds. Or you stop and look and understand that life needs sunshine and rain. See, God knows that rain makes grass greener. And rain is not a bad thing. Rain is whatever you want to make out of it. I know people who sit in their houses because it's raining outside. One of my most favorite memories, and I have many, with one of my little grandchildren, my little granddaughter Bailey. One of her most favorite memories, and she has many with me. She's only 10. But one of her most favorite memories is one day when she was up at the house, it was summer, and it was warm out and it started raining. And I said, Bailey, come on, we're going to walk in the rain. Oh, she said, Mimi, I don't have any clothes to walk in the rain. I said, well, you've got clothes on. Let's just go walk in the rain in them. It doesn't matter. She said, are we not going to take an umbrella? I said, no, we don't need an umbrella. We're going to get wet. We're going to get wet in the rain. We're going to skip in the rain. We're going to look up and let the rain hit us on the face and drink it while it falls on our faces. Oh, we had the best time walking down the lane of the farm, just letting it rain. And she has this beautiful long blonde hair. And I have this big curly hair, dark hair. And the further we walked, the flatter our hair got. And the more we laughed. That's joy. Do you understand that you need to hear birds singing? Do you understand that you're alive? You're a living being created by God to have Him love you and to have a life that you can enjoy in abundance to the full till it overflows. My Kentucky daddy always used to say, Rose, look for opportunities to make people important, feel important, and to have joy in their life. My dad loved to laugh. And for a long time, I didn't laugh. Maybe it's been a long time since you haven't laughed. Maybe it's been a long time that you haven't even realized. Even to think about it is a surprise to you. Well, beloved, if you haven't laughed for a long time, then you've almost forgotten what it is to live a good life. You've almost forgotten what it is to feel good. And it's great to laugh, isn't it? It's great to laugh and have the joy of the Lord because that's our strength. I tell people when they want to enjoy what they eat, I don't know if you like breakfast or not, but if you enjoy breakfast and pancakes, then buy you some real maple syrup. Don't get the fake kind. Just go get you some real maple syrup and put butter in it and pour it all over something. Heat it up. That's enjoying life. See, you don't have to do big things. You don't have to take trips to the other side of the world and go on African safaris. And I know a lot of people, my friends, that have done that. And I've gone around the world a lot of times looking for happiness and looking for joy. And it was right in my house. It was right in my backyard, as they say. It was right on my farm. It was right in my own heart. It was right in the Lord. And joy is the thing that God wants you to have because it's strong. He wants you to have love too and faith, but joy is another fruit of the Spirit that He wants you to have. Be grateful. Never, never, never withhold saying, I love you. You did a good job. I have staff in my office, and sometimes it gets very busy and very high, strung, powerful, intense. Things are happening so fast, and a lot is going on. And I forget to say, you've done a good job. And then the Lord stops me and tells me, I want you to remember to say that, Rose, because you like to hear it. So does everybody else. See, alcohol and drugs, sexual addictions, pain, anger, bitterness, ignorance, fear, all those things will leave you. They'll leave you because joy is happiness and it's thankfulness. And they'll leave you when you have the joy in the Lord, and joy is your strength in the Lord. That's what God's talking about, making you strong. He wants you to have a sense of humor. He wants you to learn to get rid of hard feelings. He wants you to get rid of them and make room for happiness. You know, happiness is doing for other people. That's what happiness is. And it makes you strong along with your joy. Love and happiness is when you do for yourself. Oh, that's a big one, isn't it? How many times do we do for so many people? And we don't do for ourselves. We don't take care of ourselves. We don't take care of take time to take care of our own minds, our own hearts, our own bodies. We just don't take the time. Well, I want you to understand today, joy makes you strong. And joy is something that takes care of you. It gives you fresh, new power. You don't want to miss out on life. And real quick here, I'm going to give you about three or four scriptures, because there's two things that hinder your joy, or that just absolutely will destroy it. Two things, fear and ignorance. Ignorance is not the same as stupidity. See, ignorance means you don't know something. Stupidity means you know something and you just don't do it anyway. You just say, I know that, but I'm not going to do that. That's stupidity, especially if it's good for you. So fear is a big factor. And Psalm 23:4 says, and write these down, or when you call the ministry, ask for the DVD of the program and we'll send it to you, and you can write all these down then. Psalm 23:4 says, I will fear or dread no evil or harm, for you are with me. Psalm 56:4 says, in God, whose word I praise, on God I lean, rely, and confidently put my trust without fear. What can mortal man do to me who is flesh? What can he do to me? Isaiah 41:10 says, fear not, there's nothing to fear, for I'm with you. Do not look around you in terror and be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen and harden you to difficulties. Yes, I will help you. Yes, I will hold you up and retain you with my victorious right hand of rightness and justice. Luke 12:32. Do not be seized with alarm and struck with fear, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Romans 8:15, for the spirit which you have now received is not a spirit of slavery to put you once more in bondage to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, the spirit producing sonship, in the bliss of which we cry, Abba, Father. Beloved, God did give you a spirit of fear. He delivered you from fear that is a spirit, and it's tormenting. Fear is dangerous. It's dark. It has a tormenting side, and it will despair you to the point of even being depressed. And depression will lead you into manic depression, and that will even lead you into wanting to kill yourself. That's suicide. That's suicide thoughts. And I know what it is to feel those kind of pains. I know what it is to not have the joy as my strength of the Lord. I know what it is to think that I can't go on another day. And I can talk to you more about that when you call me. But I want you to know today, whatever's going on in your life, you can lay it down and let God have it. You can give it to Him and say out loud, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, O God. I will say of the Lord, He is my good shepherd, and He leads me beside still waters. I will say of the Lord, He is my joy. I love you so much. I'm going to be back in just a minute, and when I come back, I want you to pay attention to the offers for the books and write down the phone number and call in and let me know you want what your books are being offered to Keep It Simple and God's 30 Days, the Champion in You. And I love you. I'll see you in just a minute. Praise God. I know I have a powerful word for the, from the Lord for you when you call me to pray with you. I'm Rose. This is Clear Vision. I'll see you in just a minute.
Love says, keep it simple. This timely teaching by Rose will keep you loving and being blessed at all times. You'll learn how to never quit, surrender to love, take and make time, treasure time, and become a blessed spiritual athlete. Are you ready to live blessed beyond your dreams? Are you ready to be God's great blessing? Learn how to keep it simple. Order your book today and walk in divine health, increase your finances, and increase your joy and blessings. And remember to request your 30-day devotional, 30 Days, the Champion in You.
Glory to the Lord. If you're still with me, that's so cool. And if you're not and you've just joined me, praise the Lord. You're going to get to hear about the joy of the Lord as your strength. And we're going to talk again about what fear does in our lives. And the little book that they've offered you, this powerful, powerful book with messages in it, scripture, teachings, prayers, keep it simple. Order that book and learn how to have a blessed life beyond anything you've ever asked. Order 30 Days, the Champion in You, and that will answer every need you have for 30 days, emotionally, mentally, physically, healing, spiritually, financially. Scriptures on all those things are in this little 30-day devotional, and it's called 30 Days, the Champion in You. So order that book and order Keep It Simple, and I'm teaching from Keep It Simple today. And let's look at 2 Timothy 1:7, because we're talking about fear, the power of fear, and the fact that you have been delivered. I have been delivered. As a believer in the Lord, we have been delivered from fear that is a spirit. Fear is a spirit that we have been delivered from, and we have been delivered into the Son's love, which is perfect. And perfect love casts out all fear. Amen? And 2 Timothy 1:7 says, "For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, of cowardice, of craving and cringing and fawning fear, but He has given us a spirit of power and of love and of calm and of a well-balanced mind and discipline and self-control." Well, when you have that calm, well-balanced mind, discipline, and self-control, you can't help but be walking in the joy of the Lord. And joy is your strength. And then 1 John 4:18 says, "There is no fear in love. Dread does not exist, but perfect love casts out fear because fear has torment." Beloved, joy and love snip the roots of fear. Just get right down in there and cut them off. Because you can't have joy and be afraid. And you can't be afraid and have joy. And joy is your strength. And the devil can't stand up against it. There's two things the devil can't stand against. Joy and love. He can't stand it. He hightails it. Because when you're joyful and you're loving, you're praising the Lord. And the praises of God send the devil running. Sends the devil into the furthest pits of the corner of hell. And that's where you want to keep him. Let's take time today to pat ourselves on the back. Oh, no, Rose, you couldn't be saying that. Well, the Bible says in Psalm 8:5, and let's just read it exactly. Psalms 8:5 says, "Yet you have made him but a little lower than God for heaven." For heavenly being or heavenly beings, and you have crowned him, meaning you and me, with glory and honor. You made him, you and me, to have dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under his feet. That's you and me. That's you and me with the Lord Jesus. Everything's under your feet. God's Word is perfected in you. When you read it, when you speak it out loud, when you walk in the joy of it as your strength, and joy is the strength. Joy gives you strength, okay? Then you are crowned with God's glory and honor. Crowned. You have a crown on with God's glory and honor. That's why when you walk in a room, you light up the room because you have the crown of God's glory and honor on you and the joy. When I was a kid, I like to talk about that a lot because I was raised in this fabulous, loud, mountain, eastern Kentucky Italian family. When I didn't get my way, I would do what they call sourpuss up. See, you get your face all screwed up, and you start whining and crying, and laying in the floor and kicking a little bit, and go pound on a door or two. And that's what you do when you try to get your way the wrong way. But my daddy would always come to me, and he'd say, "Honey, have you ever thought about what would happen if your face froze like that?" And I didn't know what I looked like. And so one day I went to the mirror. And I couldn't believe how I looked. Do you know how you look when you're sourpussed up, when you're all complaining and criticizing and discouraged? And it takes a whole lot more muscles to frown than it does to laugh. Amen? And it takes a whole lot more muscles to sit still than it does to get up and move. Because the muscle you need to get up and move and do something sometimes is the muscle in your mind, the muscle in your emotions, the muscle of your spirit, not just your body. It takes a decision. God wants you to applaud yourself today. Pat yourself on the back. Applaud yourself. Congratulate yourself that you're glorifying God by recognizing the goodness of His grace. You may be in a place today where this is the first time you've ever heard anybody talk like this. Well, then pat yourself on the back that this is the first time you're hearing it. And just thank God that you're hearing it and that you're going to learn how to put it in practice. Say out loud with me today, "I have great joy as one of my living fruits of my powerful Holy Spirit." Because God has given you the fruit of joy. Joy is a fruit. It's a result of one of the fruits of the Holy Spirit. By that we mean that the Holy Spirit indwells in you. That's Christ in the spirit form dwelling in you. He's in you. You're of Him, by Him, with Him, from Him, in Him. He's in you. And He is full of the joy of Father God. By the grace of God, say out loud, "By the grace of God today, I am somebody marvelous." That sounds really strange if you've never said something like that before. But see, Psalm 139 says, "I knew you before I created you in your mother's womb. And I created you marvelous and intricately. God created you marvelous. So talk about it. Just speak it out loud. Say, "God loves me so much that He would stop at nothing to save my soul." That's what He did when Jesus died on the cross. That's proof. Proof. Proof of how much God loves you. Proof that He'll stop at nothing, even to allow His own Son to die for you. Because He knew, God knew you're going to come to Him. He knew that. And if you haven't received the Lord, then today is that day. Call my office and let's pray together. And let's receive Him together. Say, "Thank you, Lord. I'm building up others around me through my joy and my love and faith. And I have survived a great deal. Oh God, thank you. You're growing me spiritually." You see, God is moving you ahead step by step. He wants you to understand that you can have a walk worthy of Him. 1 Thessalonians 2:12 tells us that God is moving us step by step, and He's moving us inch by inch. I like to say if we move inch by inch, we stay off the bench. I don't know how you think, but I played basketball when I was a young girl in high school. And the bench wasn't anywhere I wanted to be. I was the action gal. I wanted to be out on the floor. I wanted to dribble the ball. I wanted to shoot the ball. I wanted to keep the ball even sometimes. But God don't want you sitting on the bench of life. He wants you out going, doing, having a great time in His joy. He wants you moving just a step a day, just one step a day. And then the next thing you know, you'll take two steps a day. And the next day, three steps. And the next day, four steps. And before you know it, what's going to happen is you'll be having big opportunities face you in the name of Jesus. See, God wants you to have opportunities. He doesn't want you to sit by quietly, piously, saying, "Oh, well, I'm just waiting for God to drop a miracle out of a cloud." Well, honey, He can do that. But He wants you to take steps. In the old Western days, in the old Wild West days, in the farms back then, they had an old saying called "bite the bullet." And that literally was when there was no painkillers back then. We didn't have Advil, Tylenol. I don't need them, so I don't take a whole lot of them. But back then, if you were having a struggle with something, you just bit the bullet. And it literally was true. They took a bullet, bit down on it, and bared up. They bared up under unbearable circumstances. I know there's someone watching that has an unbearable circumstance today that you think you can't make it through. But God says, we're going to bite the bullet, and we're going to stand in the joy of the Lord. We're going to stand and decide that we're going to be all that God says we are. We're going to have all that God says we can have. We're going to do all that God says we can do. And we're going to be the person that God says we are, His royal grand champion winner. I was invited to go to a home one time of a young lady living in a wheelchair. And I'll tell you this real quick. No, I don't even have time to tell you. You're going to have to call the office. They've just shown me I have 30 seconds, and I can't say anything in 30 seconds. So you call my office, and I'll tell you about the young woman living in the wheelchair and what happened to her when she got the joy of the Lord. God bless you for watching. I love you. This is Clear Vision, and I'm Rose. And until I see you again, smile as you praise the Lord and you answer the phone.